Hello students, let us learn another topic related to chapter 2. So in the last video we have learnt about a closure property of whole number. Let us learn associative property of whole number, so which is also similar to closed number, closure property. Okay, so here you have to just check whether this property satisfy the addition and multiplication. So you have associative of addition. So here I have a plus b plus c is also equal to a plus b plus c. So I'm going to apply a bracket for a plus b and here b plus c. So let us apply some of the numbers for in the place of alphabets and let us see whether the associative of addition satisfy or not. So let us think a is 2, b is 3 and c is 4. If you want any other numbers you can apply it. So I am applying a as 2 plus b is 3, okay, and c is 4. So the same way a is 2 you have to apply here, 2 plus b is 3. So according to Bodmer's rule, you know that first we have to solve the bracket problems, okay. We have to solve the bracket, okay. 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 plus 4 is equal to write 2 as it is plus 3 plus 4 is 7. So 5 plus 4 is 9 and 2 plus 7 is 9. So the associative property of addition satisfied by watching this example. Okay, let us see associative of multiplication. So here you have a into b into c and a into b into c, and I'm going to apply the bracket as we have applied in the addition. So let us apply the same number to avoid the confusion. Okay, so 2 into 3, the value of a is 2, b is 3 and c is 4. Again here also 2 into 3 into 4. Okay, 2 into 3 is how much? Yes, it is 6. 6 into 4, again write 2 as it is. 3 into 4 is how much? It is 12. Okay, now 6 into 4 is, what is the answer? It is 24. And 2 into 12 or 12 into 2, how much? Yes, it is 24. So the both the side we got the same answer. So that we come to a conclusion that associative property of addition and multiplication or both are satisfy. I hope you understood with this topics. So students, let us learn one more topic related to your exercise or less chapter 2. Okay, so we have learned with closure property, associative property, the last property you have distributivity of multiplication over addition. So in this property you will be having two sums, that is even addition and multiplication. All that you have to do is you have to split the numbers and you have to find the product. Okay, I'll show you by the example. Here you have a plus b into c. So let us keep a as 5 or a is equal to 10, b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 5. So if this is a case or this is a sum asked to you to solve, what you have to do, you have to distribute c into a, then c into b. So c into a is ac plus again c into b is bc. So where c is a common factor for a and b. Okay, let us apply these numbers in the sum and let us solve the problem. Okay, so 10 plus 3 into 5. Now what you have to do, you have to multiply first 5 into 10. So 10 into 5 plus 3 into 5. So 10 into 5 is how much? It is 15. Plus 3 into 5, it is 15. Okay, if you add 50 plus 15, the answer is 65. So this is what a distributivity of multiplication over addition. I hope you understood with this topic. Thank you so much for watching the video.